All right, this next one can be a little tricky. Remember, the first place that we start out is to check your x's. Are they the same? No, so it's not a vertical line. Check your y's. Are the y's the same? No, so it's not a horizontal line. So we gotta find the slope. So slope looks like this. y2 minus y1, 1 minus 5, over x2 minus x1, minus 1 minus 1 half. Now this is where sometimes students get a little bit upset about this one. 1 minus 5 is a negative 4. And then we all can pretty much do this. 1 minus 1 half, that's money, right? A dollar minus a half dollar is a half. But then you look at that and you might go, oh, I don't know what to do with that. Well, remember that that fraction bar is division. So this really says negative 4 divided by 1 half. And usually, as soon as I put it in that term, students go, oh, I can do that. And that was the case all along. Yes, you could do it. So we have negative 4 times a reciprocal of a half, which is 2. And so now we see that our slope is a negative a. So now that we have our slope, we got to check and see, do I have a y-intercept? Nope. No y-intercept. So because I don't have a y-intercept, now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to plug into point slope form. So y minus, I'm not going to use that point. Are you crazy? I'm going to use this point over here. That's much nicer. So I'm going to put in y minus y1, which is 1, is equal to negative 8 times x minus x1, and x1 is 1 there. And now I'll simplify. So y minus 1 is equal to, distributive property happens here and here, so negative 8 times x, which is negative 8x, and then negative times a negative, which is positive, so that's a positive 8, and then we're going to move the constant over, so we'll add a 1 here, and we'll add a 1 here, and then we have y is equal to negative 8x, and then plus 8 plus 1, which is 9. And so now we have slope-intercept form. And we can check and see if it satisfies this. So 1 half of 8 is a negative 4, and a negative 4 plus 5 is, or 9 is 5. And yep, check, it does satisfy it. All right, moving right along, we're going to be taking a look at this last scenario if we have the graph. So if we have the graph, as in example number 22, it's not going to change from before, right? We're going to find that this slope, we're going to find it visually. So my slope, I'm going to get from the rise over the run. So I'm going to go down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I went down, so a negative 5, and then I'm going to go back 1, 2, 3, 4, so that's a negative 4, and I'm going to simplify that to a positive 5 over 4, of course. No mixed numbers, no decimals, just an improper fraction there. But then you see, look at this. I don't have an integer ordered pair. I'm not really sure what that y-intercept is, so I don't have the y-intercept given. So I just have to have one of these ordered pairs. So either one will do. So remember, to find the ordered pair, we come back to the x-axis, and we see that's 3 on the x-axis. And we come back to the y-axis, and we see that's 2 on the y-axis, and see we have an ordered pair. Now we can use point slope form. So y minus y1, which is 2, is equal to slope 5 fourths times x minus x1, which is 3, and now we can simplify. So distributive property here and here, so y minus 2 is equal to 5 fourths times x, and then minus, and 5 times 3 is 15, and those are fourths. Now again, don't freak out because it's fractions. I'm just going to say here, okay, well, in order to add that over there, I'm going to have fourths, right? So times 4 down here, and so times 4 up here. And so on this side, I'm going to be adding 4 times 2, which is 8, 1 times 4, which is 4, and I'm going to add 8 fourths over here. And now I can simplify it. Y is equal to 5 fourths times x, and then minus 15 minus 8, which is 7, and those are fourths. And so there's my equation. And just like before, I can check to see if that other ordered pair is satisfied, satisfies this equation, and therefore if it is actually my equation. And so again, I could go down here and go, this is a negative 1 and this is a negative 3.